In this video, we're thinking about the continuity equation for the flow of an incompressible fluid, but there's a complication. I have this larger diameter pipe with diameter D, and there's a given fluid speed V sub capital D, but then the pipe splits into two identical pipes that are smaller, and they're given this general symbolic diameter of little d with a speed of V sub little d. We're asked two parts in this question. First, we want the total flow rate, in other words, volume per second, in terms of the large diameter part of the system. And then in part B, we want to express the fluid velocity in the smaller pipes in terms of the large diameter, the small diameter, and the fluid speed in the large diameter part. So we start by writing down the flow rate, and flow rate is always cross-sectional area times the speed of the fluid. And I'm going to subscript these. That's the flow rate in the large part, so I'll put a big D on that, the cross-sectional area of that part, the fluid speed of that part. And I'll post a link to the video where I first derived this flow rate equation. So we want the cross-sectional area and we have the diameter. One way to do this is to say the cross-sectional area is pi r squared, but then you have to divide the diameter by 2. I would prefer to handle this algebraically by just squaring the d over 2 and bringing the factor of 1/4 out in front. So my cross-sectional area is 1/4 pi diameter squared. And then my fluid speed was V sub big D. And that's it. We have our flow rate expressed in terms of the diameter and the fluid speed of the fat part of this pipe. Now we want the fluid speed in the smaller pipes. And what I'm going to do is express the flow rate in one of these pipes in terms of the cross-sectional area and the fluid speed. And I'm going to call that F little d, that's equal to the cross-sectional area of a small pipe times the fluid speed in the small pipe. And we do the same thing. I write 1/4 pi diameter squared, but it's a little d. And there's the flow rate in one of the pipes. And what we know is exactly the same amount of fluid must be passing through the system at any point. And that means the flow rate in the fat part of the pipe must be equal to twice the flow rate in one of the skinny pipes, because when I put those two pipes together, I get the same flow rate as the original big pipe. So we go ahead and plug in what we found for the flow rate in the large part, 1/4 pi diameter squared times the fluid speed in the big part of the pipe. That's got to be equal to twice the flow rate in one of the little pipes that it split into. So that's twice 1/4 pi little diameter squared V little d. So we can cancel out the 1/4 and the pi. And what we're trying to do here is find the fluid speed in the smaller pipes. So we divide by 2 little d squared, and we end up with a nice expression for the fluid speed in the smaller pipes. That's big D squared over 2 little d squared times the fluid speed in the large pipe. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.